Hi friends, we'll discuss now kinetics of particles. Kinetics means analysis of motion, considering masses of the particles and the forces which causes the motion. This branch of dynamics is called as kinetics. Therefore, whenever we'll study about kinetics, we have to deal with forces as well as masses of the particle. In kinetics of particles, there are three parts. Kinetics of particles 1, called as D'Alembert's principle. Kinetics of particles 2, work energy principle. And kinetics of particles 3, where we'll study impulse, momentum, collision between elastic bodies. Now, in this lecture, we'll study about work energy principle. Work energy principle. In short, it is also written as WEP. Let's assume one block is at rest on horizontal plane. Say this one is a block which is at rest on horizontal plane. If we'll draw free body diagram of this block, weight of this block acts in downward direction and we'll get reaction which is developed at contact surface. Therefore, say this one is weight of this block, which is say M into G. Here what we'll get? Normal reaction Rn acting on the block. Now, if this block is subjected to a resultant force which acts in say horizontal direction, say this one force which is acting on this block is acting in rightward direction. Say magnitude of force is say P, or may be considered as F. Assuming frictionless surface, resultant force acting in horizontal direction is in rightward direction. Therefore, as any force acts on a body, or resultant force acts on a body, body always accelerates as per Newton's law. As per Newton's law, F equal to mass into acceleration. That means whenever any resultant force acts on a body, say F, on a body having mass equal to m kg, body accelerates with a meter per second square. That means as on this block of mass m kg, this force P is acting, this block starts its motion in rightward direction and accelerates in rightward direction. Now, as it accelerates in rightward direction, if I'll represent here some position, initially block is at this location. Now, once force P is applied, then it accelerates. That means say one more position, say position 1, again block moves in rightward direction. I'll represent one more position here, say position 2. As body is subjected to acceleration and that is also in rightward direction, velocity of block increases as it moves in rightward direction. Therefore, at this position 1, if I'll represent, say this one is a position of block, which one is at a distance of say x1 from its initial position. This is initial position. Now at position 1, I'll represent position is say x1, and as it passes through position 1, its velocity will assume say v1. Again, force is continuously applied on the body. Therefore, body is subjected to acceleration and body continues its motion in rightward direction. As mass of this block is m, as per Newton's law, F equal to ma, body continues or body oscillates in rightward direction. After some time, next time instant, body passes through this position too. I'll represent again here this position. Mass of block is same, m. Force is still acting on the body. This one is force P. Now this location or this position I'll represent here as position 2, which is at a distance of x2 from its initial position. And this block attains some velocity, say V2, as at position 2. That means initially force P is applied on the body. As per Newton's law, block of mass m accelerates. When it passes through position 1, it attains velocity V1 when its position is x1 from its initial location. Again, motion continues due to its acceleration. It attains some different velocity V2. Mass of block is m kg and its position from initial position is say x2. Now, as per this equation F equal to ma, if I'll write this equation as F equal to mass into this acceleration, if we'll write in terms of velocity and in terms of displacement as V dv by dx. Acceleration is dv by dt, multiplying and dividing throughout by dx, what will get V dv by dx. That means this equation is written as what? F into dx equal to m v dv. Where it represents what? When force F acts on a body, or here this is resultant force, here what force is acting is P, that means F equal to P. For this small displacement dx, velocity of block varies by this dv. As force P is acting in rightward direction, for small displacement dx, change in velocity is dv. Now if you want to analyze from position 1 to position 2, we'll integrate this equation from position 1 to 2, where limits of, you can say, displacement means dx is varies from x1 to x2 and velocity varies from v1 to v2. Therefore, integrating this equation, just see next page. If we'll integrate it, integral of f dx equal to integral of m v dv. If we'll integrate this one from x1 to x2, when position is x1, velocity is v1, and when position is 2, that means x2, velocity is v2. Therefore, if we'll integrate now, what we'll get? F into x, where x varies from x1 to x2, which is equal to integral of mv dv is mv square by 2. That means half m v square, where this velocity varies from v1 to v2. Substituting here upper limit and lower limit, what will get here? F upper limit is x2 minus lower limit is x1 equal to half m upper limit is v2, v2 square minus lower limit is v1. So what will get here? V1 square. F into this x2 minus x1 represents displacement of this block from position 1 to 2. Therefore, this one is also written as F into, say, delta x, which is equal to, now this one becomes half m v2 square minus half m v1 square. Force into displacement is nothing but work done by this force when its displacement is delta x. Therefore, this one is written as work done by forces and displacement when body moves from position 1 to 2. Therefore, W1 to 2 equal to half m v square is kinetic energy. What term you are getting is half m v2 square. Therefore, this one is kinetic energy of this block when it is at position 2 minus half m v1 square represents kinetic energy at position 1. Therefore, this one is relation between work done by forces when body moves from position 1 to 2, and that is equal to kinetic energy at position 2 minus kinetic energy at position 1, which represents a relation between work done and kinetic energy of this block having mass equal to m kg. This relation is called as work energy principle. Normal type of problems that can be solved using work energy principle are what? Work done, force into displacement, kinetic energy, half m v square. That means if displacement is known, we'll find out maybe velocity at final position using this principle. Work done by forces is K2 minus K1, what it represents when work is done by forces when body moves from 1 to 2 is final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. That means work done by forces is change in kinetic energy. For this work done, what is important? This work done term is very important. Basically, work done is always product of two terms. It is force into displacement. Now this one general equation, force into displacement, but what is important here? Direction of force and displacement. If force is horizontal and displacement is inclined, then you have to consider displacement in the direction of force. Sometimes maybe displacement horizontal, force inclined. So what force is acting in the direction of displacement? Therefore, this one is written as what? Force into displacement in the direction of force. Force into displacement in the direction of force. Or this one is force in the direction of displacement. Force in the direction of displacement into displacement of block. That means direction of force and displacement, what we are getting here, that must be same. Force vertical, so displacement must be vertical. When this work done is positive and when this work done is negative, that is also important. Therefore, what is important here? If direction of force, if direction of force and displacement, direction of force and displacement are same. If direction of force and displacement are same, then work done is positive. Then work done is positive. Sometimes maybe you may get motion in some direction and force which is acting is in opposite direction, which is always possible or always will get for frictional force because it opposes the motion. Therefore, you may get negative work done also if direction of force and displacement, if direction of force and displacement are opposite, then work done is negative. That means while finding work done by any force during motion, you have to concentrate the force is acting in which direction and displacement of block is in which direction. Again, we'll discuss this part. If you want to find out work done, for example, say this one is a block which is resting initially on horizontal plane. If we'll draw a free body diagram, weight will get in downward direction, say mg. What will get here? Normal reaction. Now if block moves in rightward direction, say this one is displacement, but now what force is acting on the block is not horizontal. If force acting on this block is say inclined force p inclined at an angle of theta. Now displacement, you know it is in horizontal direction, but force p is inclined. Therefore, you have to find out what force is acting in the direction of displacement. That means if we'll resolve this P, what will get here? P cos of theta. Therefore, in this case, work is done by this P cos of theta, because it is acting in a horizontal direction, into this displacement dx. Now, other forces what we are getting here, so component of P is acting in downward direction, which one is equal to what? P sin theta. P sin theta in vertically downward direction. Mg means weight of block acting in downward direction. Normal reaction acting in upward direction. What is the work done by P sin theta or Mg or normal reaction? All these three forces are acting in vertical direction, but displacement of block is in horizontal direction. That means there is no displacement in vertical direction. Therefore, work done by all these three forces, P sin theta, Mg and Rn is zero. That means when will get work done by any force as zero? If forces acts perpendicular to the direction of motion, perpendicular to the direction of motion, then work done by forces equal to zero. That means always you have to concentrate which force acts in the direction of displacement, in the direction of motion. Here only one force is acting in horizontal direction or in the direction of displacement, and that is also direction of force and displacement shape. Therefore, we will get work done by only P cos theta, and that work done is positive because direction of force and displacement are same. Similarly, if I will take here say a block which one moves along inclined plane, inclined at an angle of theta. Say this one is a block having some weight W. Say this one is weight, that means Mg. Now if we'll try to find out work done by forces when this block moves in downward direction by this displacement dx. Now motion is along the plane downward. Now if we'll represent various forces as inclination of plane is theta with horizontal, this angle what will get is theta. If we'll resolve, we'll get one component here, W cos theta. One more component we'll get here, which acts along the plane. Component is W sin theta. Normal reaction acts on this block. Say this one is what? Rn. If mu is given, that means coefficient of friction is given, you'll get here frictional force which opposes the motion, whose magnitude is equal to mu into Rn. Now work is done by which forces? First, direction of displacement is important. Displacement is along the plane downward. So first you check which forces are acting along the plane. Along the plane you are getting two components. One is W sin theta, other one is mu Rn. That means work done by W cos theta and Rn are zero. You will get work done only by W sin theta and mu Rn. Again, displacement is in downward direction. Therefore, work done by W sin theta becomes positive and work done by mu Rn is negative, because mu Rn means frictional force is acting in opposite direction of motion. In this case, work done is equal to W sin theta into dx. This one is positive, and work is done by this frictional force, which is mu Rn, into this displacement, this dx. Now this mu Rn means frictional force. This always acts in opposite direction of motion. Therefore, any problem whenever we'll get this work done, or any frictional force, the work done by frictional force, work done by frictional force is negative. Why it is always negative? Because direction of force, frictional force, is always opposite to the direction of motion. Thank you.